Good morning all, welcome to the channel. What another beautiful day, honestly. June 2023, man, so far. Absolutely amazing. So I've had to drop the van off in Chorley today. I thought I'm going to use the opportunity to go and have a look at Healey Nab. Not been to Healey Nab for a while now. Somewhere that I used to go quite a lot when I first started mountain biking around the Rivington area. Location wise, it is, if you look for it on a map, it's northwest of Angles Arc Reservoir. Pretty easy to reach by road and then by this track. Easily accessible, trail centre type trails with some berms and a few jumps and drops and things like that. So let's go and check it out. So I'm riding solo today, no Hugo, not sure distance wise what I'm going to finish on today, so I didn't want to punish him. It's really warm again as well, so quite a lot of flat miles and some road miles for me to get home. Okay, so we just hang a left and we've got the first of the fairly sharp but short-ish climbs here. Not too hard, always be pushed. Hang a left. So this was a proper woodland area, unfortunately, in I think it was 2020. There was, I don't know the technical name for it, but there was a large disease and they had to wipe out about 2,500 trees. And it's probably been 2 to 3 years since I came. I think it was just after the deforestation, so. And then we have arrived at the top. Just talking to a couple of guys there that have just set off on their descent, and they're saying that it's since the larch disease and they had the diggers in to remove the trees. I think it's been a struggle to get the conditions of the trails back to former glory. So they used to be way marked, but I think that's all gone now. So, which is a real shame, because there must have been some huge spade time gone into setting this up in the first place. But look, we'll see what we see, and we'll ride some tracks and we'll give it an appraisal when we've finished. So originally when it was built, you've basically, this were here, we've climbed up from here. There's a track which takes you back down to the start to finish. There's a red XC kind of loop that descends down to here and then starts to climb back up here. Takes you back to the start, and then there's a black downhill track. And I also think there's another on Trail Fox which isn't on here. So the intention is to follow the red if I can. Might be easier said than done with no way marks, but I'll give it a go. This kind of cheeky little rock feature there. So I can kind of like zigzag the trail a little bit. There we go. So that's the black we just crossed. And there's the black. Okay. I think we're going in the right direction. Bit of a climb though. Said it was sold as an XC loop rather than a downhill loop. Not much grip today. Very sandy. Very easy to just lose your grip. Path's crossing, quite overgrown at the side. Right, we have a junction. Don't think I took a wrong turn, but there's clearly another track there. See if I can go back up. So I've just gone back up. I'm going to try and ride this red as I think it was intended. The tracks have obviously just all molded into one, I suppose. Nice little jump. some lovely built homes there. Ooh, a bit sideways on that. First jump's always the hardest. I think that's just a bit of it. I think we're into climb now. Cheeky little wall road. That used to look really frightening when I first started riding mountain bikes, especially in the wet. Nice little rock garden. Okay, now we're climbing. So I think by modern standards, I would say that was probably when it was originally built, was more of a blue trail as it was smooth. But I think now it's degraded. There's a lot more lumps between the rocks. Sorry, gaps between the rocks. It's kind of, the trail's faded somewhat. So I'd say it's definitely now a red for sure. I believe this is the original red XC loop climb, or the middle section. Swallowing flies, zigzag your way up here. This was always quite a good fitness test, actually. Certainly good for building fitness on the bike. Punchy climbs. Ooh. It appears we've met an end. Right, so the XC climb is pretty much no more. There is this pretty well laid path though. So I think really to get back to the top, it's an efficient, nice way. You're just not practicing your single track skills. Finish this climb off and we'll try some more tracks. And here we are. Okay, let's see what the bike's got to offer. Some rocks there, plenty of rock features, a couple of roots in there. Nicely built up berms, but they are quite loose, so just be aware of that. Oh, lovely. That's nice. As is that. Yeah. Lovely turns. Got a bit of a cranking out of that one. It's been really, really well built. That's off to the guys, put those in for sure. And then we're back. So I'm just enjoying a moment of stillness. I've just finished reading a book called Grounded, by Ruth Allen, I think the author is, and it kind of recommends activities and things that you can do to try and ground yourself and bring yourself into the present. I'm just going to sit for 5 minutes and listen to the birds and see what colours I can see and see if I can see any squirrels knocking around and things like that. And it doesn't take more than that, and I think that will really enhance what's already been a pretty fantastic day already. So we're just going to see if this track here still exists. It takes you back to the entrance that we came in for. That was the initial climb that we did. So So the answer is yes, it does by the looks of it so far. It's a little bit overgrown in sections, but it's only a short track. Here we are. So I love beer, and Rivington Brew Company is right here, and I've never been. Pretty cool. Caravanning, glamping, if you can see that. Definitely worse spots to stay. Yes. So what's this one?
Higher than like a banshee, so it's a double dry hot pale.
Yeah.
And it's 4.5%.
Wonderful, thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Cheers, enjoy.
Cheers, thank you. Mega capital of the world. Or definitely of Rivington anyway.
Yeah, Charlie.
Look at these tasty burgers. I'm gonna go light bike today because I've still got quite a bit of riding to do, so I will have Lord of the Fries, please.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
That really is the Lord of the Fries. Delicious. Lovely hazy drink as well. Beautiful.
So I finished my little Healey Nab session, really enjoyed it actually. It's been a while since I've been here. The tree disease destroyed a lot of the trails, and there has been people digging here, and there is a group of people that dig here, and they've done a great job really putting the trails back together so they're rideable, and they are rideable. You've got to just look out for those junctions and try and remember where you've been so you can ride a different track the next time down. I think it's a great intermediate to advanced riding destination. I don't think the tracks are quite hard for beginners. I think they probably were easier when they were brand new, and there was basically the bit in between the rocks was filled. It would have been a little bit smoother. So intermediate, wanting to improve, it's a great session place for, there's some lovely berm corners, and there's some nice jumps, and there's some nice drops, there's some nice rock gardens. So if that's on your list of improvements that you want to make, it's a perfect destination for that. Mileage wise, probably done about 6 miles up and down, something like that. So I've done a bit of pedaling, I've done a little bit of pushing. Really stressed that you should check it out if you want to try some berms and drops and jumps and things like that, you want to session some corners, or if you just want to ride some downhill tracks and push back up and get some enjoyment out of it.
Wow, I'm going to have to stay a little bit, guys.